Now for today's In the Spotlight, we have a special guest with us in the studio. Joining us is the head director of the United Nations World Food Program office in Rwanda, Mr. Jean-Pierre de Margerie. Thank you very much, sir, for being here today. So please do tell us about the Saemaul Zero Hunger Communities project currently ongoing in Rwanda.
Well, it's an exciting project. It's a new project that started 2.5 years ago with the support of COICA and the government of Korea. So it's a project that looks at helping very poor communities in Rwanda fight poverty, fight hunger, and try to address their problem of food insecurity.
Mm-hmm. And the word Saemaul, I'm sure for the people in Korea, they're used to the word Saemaul, but people in Rwanda are probably not.
They're not. They're familiar with the type of community work we used to do before with them at World Food Program. But recently we've come in partnership with COICA and with the government of Korea in merging the spirit of Saemaul Undang to what we used to do. And it's yielding some very impressive benefits up to now for these very poor communities.
Mm-hmm. So what are some of the examples of those achievements so far?
Rwanda, for example, is a very hilly country, a bit like Korea mm-hmm. is. And in areas where they didn't use to produce anything out of them because of the terrain was too hilly, we managed to build these radical terraces. And we increased by basically 100% agricultural yields on these areas. So now these poor families who used to produce just enough to feed themselves, now they manage to meet their own needs, but in addition to that, they're able to sell their surpluses on the market. So for the first time, they have some cash income. So the quality of their lifestyle has increased dramatically. So that's just one component. We're building different type of infrastructure assets in the community to look at really helping them, pulling themselves out of poverty.
Mm-hmm. What kind of support then do you expect from South Korea?
Well, first of all, it was the model per se, Saemaul Undang. So that's a model that has proven itself obviously here in Korea in the 70s and 80s. And because of its universal values, principles, and concept, this can be exportable to the developing world. So we've realized this at the World Food Program, and now we're using Saemaul Undang in four countries, among them Rwanda. So it's a kind of synergy of like minds where COICA's success stories are being merged with WFP's experience in the field, mm-hmm. and it's proving to be quite successful up to now.
Mm-hmm. But there must have been some challenges, though. I mean, Saemaul Undang is from Korea, and the culture of Korea is different from that in Rwanda.
Yeah, absolutely. But you know, you look at the context of Korea in the 1970s, where the country was still quite poor.
Struggling.
And then you can draw these parallels with what you can see in the developing world and in Africa and in Rwanda. So you can draw these parallels between level of developments. But like I said earlier, you do have these kind of universal principles that can be used even in Africa. For example, you know, at the time we were talking about the importance of collaboration, the importance of being quite diligent in the management of these projects, mm-hmm. The importance of becoming self-reliance and self-help. These are still values today which are quite applicable to contexts like in Rwanda. And by applying them, now we're seeing results. So yes, it needs to be obviously adapted to the national context, but if you're smart about contextualizing your program and your approach and involving the communities from the very onset, it works.
Mm-hmm. Well, how can ordinary or general public show support in supporting and funding the program?
I think there's ways of supporting. It's a good question. Normally, WFP works mainly with government in terms of its funding. Mm-hmm. We do also do private fundraising with companies. But there are also opportunities if you go on the WFP website for individual to contribute and support.
All right. Thank you very much, sir, for your time and making the time to come to the studio and talk to us. Thank you.
Thank you.